Hi everyone and welcome back to the Astro Room, your very own portal to the cosmos. As we all know, the total solar eclipse is almost here. On April 8th, 2024, parts of the US, Mexico, and Canada will get to experience this out of this world significant event. In this video, I will show tips on how to prepare yourself if you have a C-Star or really any telescope, and how to get the best use of your C-Star S50 during this eclipse. I will also discuss the importance of safety, which is of utmost importance. Now, you don't need to live within the path of totality to see the eclipse. If you live within the United States, you will get to see at least partial or total eclipse. First, let's look at how you can know if you live within totality. And I recommend for all of you to make plans to try and see if you can experience totality if you don't live in the direct or near path. Because from what many have experienced before when seeing an eclipse like this one, this is a life-changing, full of emotions, spectacular type of event. If you don't live in the path of totality, this doesn't mean that you can't at least enjoy partial totality and still image and record the sun with your C-Star, of course. So let's find out how you can see if you live within totality, or perhaps it's near, and you can drive there or get as close as you can. Now, the website timeanddate.com, which I will link in the description, gives a great map of the path of the eclipse. This map has various degrees of colors to indicate just how much of the eclipse you will be able to see from a particular location. But if you live or are traveling to anywhere near the red dotted line in the center, that will be your absolutely best spot to see 100% totality. Now just think of what this means. You will get to see the moon completely block the sun in broad daylight, which means a revealing of the sun's outer atmosphere called the corona. Now history shows that the best spot to be in for good weather and visibility for this eclipse will be southern Texas. So if you can travel there, go for it. Of course, the weather can change at any moment, so make sure you have a backup plan in case you need to drive to another location in time before the eclipse. Now, I read that Niagara Falls is expecting over 1 million visitors for this eclipse too, because it's sort of ideally located. It really is. So it doesn't mean that Texas is the only place. Okay, so we are here on timeanddate.com, and let's look at the location to see whether you are close or which location you can drive to experience 100% totality, okay? Now, if we zoom in, you're gonna see that wherever I click right here on the left side of the screen, it shows you if that area or up to how much percentage of totality it will have, right? Do you see this city, this particular town in Texas, Beaumont, will not have 100% totality. But if I get closer to the center line, such as you see here, Austin, Texas, or Waco, Texas, you see these places have 100% totality. Okay, I'm gonna zoom out. Let's go to Toronto, Canada. Now you see it doesn't have 100% totality, it just has 99.93. Okay, if I go back, let's compare that to when I go back to, let's say, Dallas, Texas, the duration of the totality is 3 minutes, 52 seconds, okay? So when it'll experience darkness, okay? It's 100% total solar eclipse, okay? But let's say we click on Waco, check it out. The duration of totality is even longer, so that's even funner, right? You get to experience it for longer, 4 minutes and 12 seconds. So we can look up a city. So just for fun, we're going to look at Los Angeles, California. If you live in Los Angeles, you will not experience totality, right? So it says partial, 48%. Okay. So basically, as you see, the closer that we live near this, or that you travel to near this dotted line, the better, right? Which is why a lot of people will be traveling to Texas. Those of you in Little Rock, Arkansas, you got 100% eclipse. The duration of totality, though, is 2 minutes and 29. So, you know, check around to see if you go somewhere else you can see more totality. Now, you don't have to, because this is better than even so many people, right? You can actually see totality. You get to experience totality, even if it's for at least 2 minutes and a half. This is awesome. It'll give you the exact times as well. Partial begins at 12:30 p.m., right? This is all in your local time in this location. Maximum full ends at that time. So as you can see, this is a 2.5 minute period that they're talking about here, right? For this location, Little Rock, Arkansas. So yes, save this website, timeanddate.com. Look up the eclipse map. I'll put a link in the description, Eclipse Path of Total Solar Eclipse for April 8th. And you will be able to see just how much you will be able to see of the eclipse at your location. So play around with it, see if you can travel. And honestly, at this point, when you're watching this video, it might be too late to even try to travel to these places that are already going to have so many people there. And the reason why I say that is because a lot of people have already booked in advance, 6 months in advance, hotels, Airbnbs at places along this path of totality. So it might be really difficult to find a place, or at this point, any lodging or accommodations that are left are skyrocket high. So, you know, keep that in mind. If you have family and friends, though, where you can stay, that would be even better, right? Maybe your only bet would be to contact family and friends, you know, and be there a couple days, right? Wait it out and be there to see the eclipse. But other than that, you know, doesn't mean that you can't image the eclipse if you're not in this location. But of course, it's just better if you, the closer that you can get to this path of totality, right? Now, the only way to look at the sun directly during this eclipse is with special eye protection, such as eclipse glasses. We'll have a link in the description of the ones I will use and that I have used before in a prior eclipse. Keep in mind that you should never look directly at the sun unless you are wearing your specialized eye protection eclipse glasses. I cannot emphasize this enough. You will cause permanent eye damage if you do not follow that guideline. The only time that you can actually look directly at the sun without your eclipse glasses is when it's in totality. The eclipse has several phases, and only when it's in totality will you be able to take off your protective glasses, your eclipse glasses, to look at the sun directly with your naked eye. Now, there is an app, which I will put in the description as well, that does audio callouts to let you know when it is safe to look directly at the sun and take off your eclipse glasses. Please make sure that, as a rule of thumb, if it's bright or any part of the sun is visible, or when in doubt, do not look directly at the sun unless you are wearing the special glasses. Now, this is a suggestion of how to use the sea star during this eclipse, but it's coming with a warning. First, of course, make sure your sea star is leveled and you have your sun centered with object tracking. You can use the timer app or the audio callout app that I just said to let you know when it's totality, which will do basically an audio out loud call out to let you know it's time to take off your eclipse glasses. And now at this time, if you are video recording the sun with your sea star, this is the chance for you to manually take off the solar filter on the sea star, because with the filter on, you won't be able to see anything on your video recording of the sun during totality, or you won't really see much. This part, depending on where you are, can last almost 4.5 minutes if you are in the path of full totality. So at that moment, you can also play with the scenery mode during this time to see if you can get some nice videos and photos of the corona. Now wait, this act of taking off the solar filter will not be easy. As you know, the solar filter has a nice snug fit. And if you take off the filter, what can happen is you accidentally move the actual sea star scope, which will affect leveling. It may lose your sun in the recording frame. It may lose tracking. It's a chance you may be willing to take. You have to be extremely careful. But is this truly worth it? Stay with me till the end here as I explain. Once the app does the announcement to put on your eclipse glasses, you will want to put the solar filter back on the sea star. And if you had it in scenery mode, you will want to switch back to solar as well. The audio app will give you a heads up to get ready and grab your glasses. So at that time, you want to get ready to start putting the filter on and switching modes to solar if applicable. Now, no one has filmed this type of eclipse with the sea star yet, so this will truly be an experiment for anyone that's going to try this. I mean, it could completely go wrong and then you will miss out on the whole experience. None of us really know how this is going to come out until it's actually tried out. But with all the updates that ZWO, the maker of the sea star, has been doing on the app, just perhaps, just maybe, there will be a specific update for solar eclipse mode. But at this point, this is just speculation. We really don't know. Let's hope they do it though. If any of you that are watching have any other tips or suggestions, please put it in the comments for discussion. Now, if all of this sounds overwhelming to you, it's okay because to be honest, there will be tons of pictures and videos online of professionals who will have great shots of this. So just don't stress, and perhaps it will be best to just enjoy the eclipse and relax. Have your sea star recording still. Don't worry about taking off the solar filter. Just leave it on your sea star the whole time. Do record, do take pictures straight from your sea star app, have your own eclipse glasses, and just enjoy the moment with your family and friends. And don't just look at your sea star. Look up. Look up when it's in totality. Notice the surroundings around you. Look for planets in the sky. Look for stars. There will be so much to take in during the eclipse that perhaps trying to do too much with the actual sea star will have you missing out on the experience. But it's really up to you. Just please be careful, do not fry or damage your sea star, and enjoy the eclipse, everyone.